This evening is taken from Luke's Gospel, chapter 2, verses 10 and 11. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord."
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Beloved in Christ, this Christmas Eve, it is our duty and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, and to go in heart and mind to Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us hear again from the Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first day of our sin until the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make the house of prayer glad with our carols of praise. But first, because this of all things would rejoice Jesus' heart, let us pray for him, for the needs of the whole world, and all these people, for peace on earth, he came to save. For love and unity within the one church he did build, for goodwill among all peoples. And particularly at this time, let us remember the poor, the cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick and them that mourn, the lowly and the unloved, the aged and the little children, and all who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater glory, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope is in the world made flesh, and with whom, in our Lord Jesus, we forevermore are one. Would you join me in the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. This evening's service is a collection of hymns and scripture readings. We wish that you would remain seated while we sing. I know it's hard on some of them, but I think the times encourage us not to get too close together while we're singing. Our first hymn is Of the Father's Love Begotten. It's number 184 in the hymn book. Genesis chapter 3, verses 8 through 15, and then 17 and 19. God announces in the Garden of Eden Adam and Eve's punishment for their rebellion and that the seed of woman shall bruise the serpent's heel. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees in the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" And here's the big verse in all of this that condemns each of us men. "The woman whom you gave me to be with, she gave me the fruit from the tree, and I ate." And the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" And the woman said, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." And the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all the animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. She will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." To the man he said, "Because you have listened to the voice of your wife and have eaten of the tree about which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In the toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you. And you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread, until you return to the ground out of which of it you were taken. You are dust, and to dust you shall return." And our next hymn is number 196 in the hymnal, "Come Thou Long Expected Jesus."
Said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son. I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies. And by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessings for themselves, because you have obeyed my love.
Light the first candle, Advent candle, candle of hope. And our second carol is O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, number 211 in the hymnal. We'll sing the first, second, fourth, and seventh verses.
Announces the birth of a king to a people in darkness. The people who walked in darkness had seen a great light. those who live in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Next hymn is number 216 in the hymnal, Lo, How Arose Their Beam. King is coming and will usher in a reign of justice for the poor and peace for all God's creation. Micah prophesied, "But you, O Israel of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth, then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure. For now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace." And our next hymn is number 230 in the hymnal, O Little Town of Bethlehem. lesson is taken from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 35 and 38. Nancy will bring that lesson to us.
The angel Gabriel announces to the Virgin Mary that she will give birth to God's promised Son, whose kingdom shall never end. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, who you will name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
And our next carol is number 198 in the hymnal, "My Soul Gives Glory to the Lord."
This is the sixth lesson, Luke chapter 2, 1 through 7. Against a backdrop of Emperor and taxes, Jesus is born. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Then our next hymn is number 2097 in the Little Faith We Sing book, One Holy Night in Bethlehem. Child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest heaven, on earth peace among those whom he favors. Then the angels left them and gone into heaven. The shepherds said to one another, Let us now go down to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. They went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherd told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. And our next hymn is again in the Faith We Sing, number 296, Rise Up Shepherd and Follow.
Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his stars at its rising and have come to pay him homage. When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for it has been written by the prophet, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler, who is the shepherd, my people Israel. Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage. When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
And our next hymn is number 254 in the hymnal, We Three Kings.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.